On tonight's Arizona ArtBeat, we look at the Mesa Arts Center's Culture Connect program featuring the Los Angeles-based Latin dance company Contra Tiempo. The company recently performed at the center and while in residence shared their approach to the art of salsa with students and the local community.
Our work really is about anything ranging from immigration to race resistance to gender politics. We're really interested in engaging ideas of our society and our culture, using the body as a tool for expression and a way to really explore these ideas in a way that makes people think and also inspires people into action.
Ana Maria Alvarez and her fellow performers are committed to transforming the world through their art. Members of Contra Tiempo, an urban Latin dance theater company based in Los Angeles, they brought their unique style of choreography to the Mesa Arts Center this past spring. They also brought an approach to dance that fuses multiple forms with multiple perspectives.
Contra Tiempo's philosophy and mission is really to represent voices on the concert stage that aren't traditionally represented in that venue. And what I mean by the concert stage is through concert dance, so through performance, really embodying experiences and ideas and realities of the communities that we are part of and that we are represented by, which is particularly the Latino and African American communities, but really communities of color in general. Let's try this again. Wapea, wapea, basic step, inside, and adios.
An important part of Contra Tiempo's mission involves community outreach. Prior to their performance, the company partnered with the Mesa Arts Center to conduct a series of salsa dance workshops.
All people in general have the capacity to dance. We are using dance as a way to empower individuals, to create community, and to teach this idea of compassionate partnership, of being a part of a community and being a contribution to the world around them, but doing that all through dance.
Very nice.
We've been greatly expanding the role our artists play in our community when they come here. Rather than just have them come and do a concert and leave, we really think there's tremendous benefit in wherever we can, wherever the artists have the expertise, in having them spend some more time in the community, in the schools, in community centers, so that we can get the biggest benefit out of them being here.
Work it out, feel the music!
During their two-week residency, Contra Tiempo conducted workshops for students at five East Valley elementary schools, as well as at Metro High School and Mesa Community College, all part of the Mesa Arts Center's Culture Connect program.
The Culture Connect program, the real goals of that is that students are coming together through shared arts experiences and learning about diversity. They're working together as teams. They're really building these amazing 21st century learning skills that are vital to students being the next workforce. We actually did something unique with this program in that in order to build basic understanding of salsa, we sent Mesa Community College students into the classrooms that Contra Tiempo would be visiting ahead of their visit. So students were building basic salsa moves with those Mesa Community College students. Then Contra Tiempo came into the classrooms and were really able to provide a deeper learning opportunity in salsa then.
At the elementary schools, Contra Tiempo worked with sixth grade boys and girls on what was, for most, their initial experience with dance.
Our first introduction to each community that we work with is through a rueda class, which rueda is a Cuban form of salsa that's done in a circle. It's kind of like square dancing with salsa. It's a lot of fun. People love it, and it's a great way to introduce a dance form in a non-threatening environment where everybody's working together and learning alongside one another. We start with that rueda class as a way to introduce salsa, as a way to introduce partnering, as a way to introduce some of the Spanish vocabulary that comes with the dance, and as a way to really have people learn to very quickly work together and get to know a little bit more about each other and about us.
Anything that gives our children new experiences, we just jump on it. We're not just interested in academics, but we're also interested in culture, we're interested in the arts. We're interested in physical activities. We want our children exposed to all of those. And so this was a wonderful opportunity for them to do something different, completely out of the realm of what they have here normally at school.
My sixth graders, 24 kids, walked into where they normally eat lunch, and they were greeted by a professional choreographer, and they were ready for it, but they still looked like, maybe not in shock, but they were weary of what was going to happen, what they were going to have to do. We knew what the company was about, so they walked in and immediately got in a circle, and the instructor was very comfortable and kind of sent the message that today we're going to have a very comfortable dance lesson and everyone's going to have a good time. So by the end, they are, and they're clapping and they're celebrating and they feel good about themselves and they've done something that they normally wouldn't think that they could do as 11-year-olds. And so that's exciting to see.
Following the school workshops, 22 sixth graders went on to appear with Contra Tiempo as part of their concert performance. While some of those selected to participate were among the more self-assured students, others were chosen for a different reason.
Those that are confident usually are successful at something else in some other aspect of life, math, science, athletics, whatever, you know, and we're really looking to engage with those that don't have a moment of success where they might have just too much energy, right? And in the classroom, it just cannot sit down, cannot pay attention. So we want that kid. Children really, they want to learn, you know? They ask for attention, they need it, and they are so willing to give themselves, you know, more than anything.
Since I was a little girl, I used to like dancing a lot. I like moving a lot. I like all the steps to dancing, and well, that's pretty much about me being happy when I dance.
It seemed an impossible task to prepare a group of young students with little training to dance on stage with a professional company after just a few weeks of practice, and yet kids and seasoned dancers came together in performance, confirming once again the power and possibilities of the arts.
It was amazing. They were blowing our minds with how fast they were learning and how enthusiastic and excited they were. And their parents were all sitting around and watching them and feeling very proud. And so it really is. It's using dance as a way to bridge communities and connect communities that maybe sometimes have never had interactions with one another or consider themselves kind of separate parts of town. So we're hopefully using dance to unite and empower young people.